Okay, we are live. Hi, hello. Hi, Julie. How are you?
Hi, Linda. I'm good today. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for coming on. This is a little bit impromptu and then delayed. So sort of a little bit of both. But I asked Julie to come on and just chat a little bit about her experience with detoxing this time around and with, how that's gone for you. And just before we start, I just want to like catch our breath. We had some technology issues, right, to get on here today, and probably on my end, I need to figure that out. And also, just
Refrigerator issues.
refrigerator issues. So, but people will, I think, resonate with this. I or maybe not, but so my refrigerator was half freezing and then half too warm on the top. So I had the guy come, and he came this morning, and he's like, "Oh, you need a new fan." So everything had to come out, and the gift of that is I just started cleaning my refrigerator, so now it looks like it's brand new. Like every shelf, every drawer, everything is great. So that is a gift. But I was doing that right up.
Expect
Yeah,
it,
right. I mean, and it's so dirty when you start to look. It's like, oh my God. So right, it's all clean, and then it was right up until you and I decided that we would jump on here and chat. So here I am, fresh from cleaning my refrigerator, and you look fabulous.
Oh,
And
you're sweet.
I just wanted, Julie, if you would share with people, I think that you've done some detoxing in the past. I know that we're in the middle of working on your health stuff now, and how, and I know that you describe yourself as a sensitive person in terms of supplements and things that you take and how your body responds. So I would just love for people who might be going, yeah, I've detoxed in the past and it didn't work, or I'm afraid to do it, or whatever they might be thinking. What could you share about your experience so far?
Well, I appreciate sharing because my chronic health issues have gone on for a long time. And I've gone through several doctors, and either I quit or they quit because they're frustrated with me or I can't take the product. And so the biggest thing I've learned, I mean, I think I had, I've had candida and parasites and chronic fatigue and allergies and anxiety, the whole mercury, the whole issue, and obviously gut issues. And I think either they just gave up because they didn't know where to go. And I gave up because I just got sick. Every time I tried to detox, I got sick. So I think for me, the difference this time around has been unbelievable because
Okay.
I'm so sensitive and I have not really had an issue. And one of the worst things about chronic illness is if you're too sensitive because you become hopeless because you don't feel like you can take anything because, oh, here I go again, here I go again.
Yeah.
So I think the pet in the past, a lot of different products or programs I've been on, they really just want to go after and kill. Let's just kill. And here's these supplements, here's your regimen. And I buy it and I jump all in and I'm willing. I'm one of the most willing people, I mean, individuals that there is because I want to get well. But it becomes hopeless again because I get so sick. And I can get sick within a day. I get sick within 2 or 3 days, et cetera. So when I started your program, I think first I have to say one of the best, I think, jump starts I got was dealing with the diet, that you helped me on, changing first, setting that foundation, changing what I'm eating and, kind of hopefully changing some of the mucosa in my gut and some of those things. So that's a part that I want to mention because it's not just the products I'm taking. I mean, part of it's really the strength of your program initially, how you get us started. But once I started on the CellCore products themselves, I was scared because I thought, here I go again. I'm just going to feel like crap again. And but I didn't. So the thing that I think has really worked for me with CellCore is, obviously it comes in like four different kind of phases, which is, and it's easy to understand. But I think what's key is that the first phase is all about drainage. It's all about drainage and it's all about setting up your body. And I've really had to learn this. And, and I'm thinking, why was I not smart enough to figure this out myself? But it's like setting up your body to be able to handle the products before you start taking the products that are going to detox you. So, it's that mitochondria that is, are your energy and that helps you, stay energized while you're going through this, and it sets up your drainage systems, your lymphatic systems, your kidney and your liver, etc. So I drained for a long time, as you know. And, I'll say, if you're a sensitive person, you might drain longer than another person. I mean, I drained for an incredibly long time, and I, not that long, but I appreciate you sticking with me because I had to drain a month more than other people, basically. So then when I moved into the parasite, of course, I was nervous. I thought, oh, goodness, here I go. And I was able to, I started on the sensitive dose, which is just one in the morning, one at night. And I quickly moved to the two and two, and I'm now up to three and three. I would never bet my life that I could take that, those, the six a day of parasite cleansing, but it's working. I don't feel bad. There's a couple days I've felt a little off, but I drink my water, but it's nothing at all like I've experienced with other protocols. So I've been told to look a little further in my stool, and sure enough, I found some things that, we won't go in too much detail about, but it's definitely working. And what's interesting is that once I had one pretty good, I guess I could use the word dump, I just continued to feel better and better. So it's amazing. Do I still have a foggy head? Sometimes. Is it at a level 10 where it was consistently with other kills that made me just cry and stop? No, not at all. It's so gentle that it allows me to keep going and going. And I'm actually looking forward to, we're gonna repeat phase two, just because, as you know, my tests show that I had two parasites that were definitely in my gut, and it's important that I get those out. But I'm looking forward to going to phase three and continuing on. So I, for the first time in all protocols I've ever done, I have full confidence that this is something for me, and it's something for people who are sensitive that normally can't handle those kind of products.
Well,
So
I'm so glad that you feel that way. It takes communication both of us. Is there getting feedback? I hear feedback. Is it okay?
I can hear you.
Okay. Communication. So that's what I appreciate, is that you let me know how you're feeling, and then we can adjust it. That's what I appreciate about CellCore, is that they'll say, look, everybody's different. Everybody's body's different. You may need to back down. You may need to go to one product at a time. But I don't know that if the person doesn't tell me. I don't know. I'm assuming people are doing their thing and going through. And if they're not taking their products, or they're not feeling good and they don't tell me, I can't help them and go like, okay, wait, let's figure this out. So I really appreciate that. You and I are just like we're in a partnership about it, and you let me know where you're at, and then okay, now we need to repeat this, and excuse me, you tell me what you see when you are looking, but but then
I can take pictures of those party favors. So no, yeah, no, but you're so responsive too, and that helps. I mean, that helps us as a client that I'm able to go, okay, I'm not feeling great. Well, let's just stay at this point now. And but it's the opposite for me. I'm ready to rock on. Like I said, I'm up to three and three, and I'm going to go to four and four for a couple of days and see how I do, and then I'll start my next 30 days again. But
Yeah. Well, I mean, what's great about that is when you can get your body up and tolerate those higher doses, you really hit those parasites. And like you said, we did the stool test. We saw that they're definitely there. And so to know that and know we're going after something, and then we're hitting them, because they're wily. They want to stay in your body. That's where they like living, right? That's a great environment for them. So they're doing what they can to get you to stop. They're giving off things from their body when they die, and even when they're trying to fight to stay alive, they're giving stuff off that make you don't feel well. So
yeah.
it's never a straight line. It's always, going this way and that way. I'm trying to find where my camera is.
Yeah. And I think people think that you have to go to Mexico to get parasites. And it's certainly, I've done international traveling, but everybody has them, and there's so many different kinds. I mean, you can get them from eating an apple. I mean, and people don't realize that. And as we all try to attack our issues, the fatigue, the head fog, and the, whatever we have that ails us, I mean, a lot of it starts in the gut. And I mean, our gut just cannot be healed without the parasites. And I realized that. And I was scared when I first looked at this protocol. I thought, oh gosh, I really dread that parasite part of it, but I'm flying free. So,
Yes.
and they're leaving. So, but I'll stick with it.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Julie. I just really wanted it. The reason I asked you to share that, I wanted people who have been scared about it, who have been sensitive, who are unsure if that's the way to go, or have done it before and not had results because their body wasn't prepped appropriately. I just think you're such a great candidate to let people know if they fall into those categories, there's still some possibility for them to get well. And
I think there is. And let me mention one other thing, and that is the key, I think, too, on phase two, which when I started on the parasite cleanse, is you still have the support, the mitochondria stuff and the oxygen and the kidney and liver, you know, all of those are still there. And the binders, you know, I think the binder is a key to this whole thing. And the fact that, you know, a lot of other programs, I've never been on a binder. Nobody's talked to me about a binder, you know, that when they die in your system, that those are going to actually be pulled out with a binder. And I can boost that binder, which you've taught me all this. I'm not, this is a textbook. This is you teaching me, but you know, I'm able to take that and, or increase my binder and they go. I mean, they bind and get out of there. So that's just a real important thing, I think, especially for sensitive people to know.
Yeah. Yeah. You're so right. The binders are huge. And when you go through the whole protocol, it's not only parasites. We start there so that the gut is doing a good job. And then we go to the rest of the body. So the first binder is the biotoxin binder. So that's binding to biotoxins like parasites, biological things. Then a little bit further down the line, they have a Virad Chem binder, which is binding to viruses, radiation, and chemicals. So that's like the next level. Now that we've got a gut that can handle it, let's start to pull that out. So Epstein-Barr virus, other viruses that are in our environment and whose, you know, we're all very, very much aware of how much that can impact us, right? Viruses, and they're going to be out there. But radiation from the EMFs, from all of the technology that we're swamped in, the radiation there and the chemicals, industrial chemicals, cleaning chemicals. So that's the second round of binders, and it's different stuff. You know, you need different things to go after those things. And then at the end, they have heavy metals and HMET. So that's heavy metals, looking for the mercury from your teeth, arsenic, lead, all of that. So it's very specific. It's very strategic. And it's changeable depending on how a body is reacting. So I love that. And I love you for sharing your.
I love you too. And I have a lot of those things to look forward to with mercury, different things. So I just appreciate the program and you sticking with me and all your guidance.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you so much. I want to wish you and whoever decided to hop on and listen a great weekend. So we just get it started this way, talking about parasites. I hope you have a good weekend. Enjoy time with your horse. I know that makes you happy.
It does make me happy. Thanks, Linda. You have a good weekend too.
Yeah. You're welcome. Thank you.
All right. Bye. Bye.